Welcome to the course of Microwave Engineering. In today's class, we are going to learn about avalanche transit time devices. So as per the syllabus, we are just going to give an introduction to what are these avalanche transit time devices. So in the previous topics like gun diode and gun oscillations, we have seen the concept of VI characteristics of a gun diode, right? So what's happened there? As the voltage increases, the current also increases up to a critical level or a particular peak point. So after that peak point, what happened? As the voltage increases, the current gradually decreases. Okay, that is what we have seen in a VI characteristics of gun diode, right? So this process of having a delay between that particular voltage and current along with this transit time is said to be negative resistance. So here also the avalanche transit time or the avalanche transit time devices discuss about the same thing. So the process of having a delay between the voltage and current, as we have seen, okay, in the gun diode VI characteristic, same happening here. So the process of having a delay between voltage and current. So as the voltage increases, current also increases. At a particular point, as the voltage increases, current decreases, right? So that's the delay between the voltage and current. So in the avalanche together with respect to the transit time, okay? So this particular process can said to be negative resistance. We have seen, right? The fall of a current when the voltage increases can be said to be a negative resistance, right? So all the devices or the diodes which exhibit this property can also be called as avalanche transit time devices. Okay, so the devices that helps to make a diode exhibit this kind of property are called as avalanche transit time devices. So we have a several devices or the diodes like impact, trapped and buried diodes. Okay, so these are the examples of the devices that comes under this particular kind of category. They are nothing but impact diodes, trapped diodes and buried diodes. Okay, so simply we can say that impact, trapped and buried diodes are considered to be avalanche transit time devices, where we can see the delay between voltage and current with respect to the transit time. Okay, now let's see these kind of devices. What is this device or the diode and what are its application? Let's see it one by one. So the first diode is our impact diode. So this is a high power semiconductor diode used in high frequency microwave applications. The left side what you see here is an impact diode. It's an a structure or a picture of an impact diode, how it looks. So it's an high power semiconductor diode used in a high frequency microwave applications. And the full form of impact diode is impact ionization avalanche transit time diode. Okay, and the applications of this particular diode is it is applied or used in microwave oscillators, microwave generators, modulated output oscillators, receiver local oscillators and negative resistance amplifications. In all these, impact diodes are used. Okay, now coming to the trapped diode, so the full form of trapped diode is trapped plasma avalanche triggered transit diode. Okay, so this is a microwave generator which operates between megahertz to gigahertz. Coming to the applications of these, they are used in low power Doppler radars, local oscillators, which are again used for radars, okay? And they are also used for microwave beacon landing systems, and they are also used for radio altimeters, etc. Okay? And coming to the next diode, it's a Barrett diode. So the full form of Barrett diode is barrier injection transit time diode. These are the latest inventions of an avalanche transit time devices family. Okay, so this is an latest diode and these are used in military communications, radars, and they are very much cost effective. They are also used in domestic consumer appliances or the applications such as DTH, telecom, and instrumentation, etc. Okay, so all these three are the diodes which falls under avalanche transit time devices, which having a delay between the voltage and current, and which proves the concept of negative resistance. Okay.